as private. So everything for simplicity purpose, it is defined as public, so that each and everything it can be accessible. And let us define everything as string. So USN, name, branch, semester, so all those things defined. And next is defined buffer. Next one again defined read function, pack function, write to file function, writing into a file, and unpack function. And after that again search, and next one is the delete from file, and next one is that modify. So first read function, and after that you can see that once you define this class, you have to end with that semicolon. So you defined it with that semicolons, and after that you are going to implement that read function. So now this read function with scope resolution operator you are going to implement. So first, very simple, you can see that already once again explained in class. So read function is nothing but reading the data. So first USN number, it's reading. Next name, next branch, next semester. So if you will call this read function in your main function, you can see that for first one it's going to read. So first it's going to read that USN number, after that name, branch, semester, all those things it's going to read. After reading, what it has to do, it has to pack. So pack is nothing but what we told, that just packing into an buffer. So packing into that buffer, so this function has been implemented. You can see that student pack that string. So we'll define that one as semester only. So this thing, let me delete. So now you can see that first it's going to define one temporary string variable in which we'll keep all those USN. So temp.erase initially we are going to flush. So in C programming you have seen that if any junk values and other things, if you have to do flush, then you are using that F flush. In this one we are using this erase. So temp.erase, it's going to empty this particular string temp. Now in temp we are going to packing all those input, whatever input we are scanned by using this read data. So first one is that USN plus, you can see that delimiter, plus name, after name delimiter, plus branch, after branch delimiter. So after that semester. So this one was that last field. After last field, we need record delimiter. So as this one is that fixed length record, rest of the byte it's going to be appended with, will append with this record delimiter itself. So for that, what we are using, that for loop, one for loop it's going to be used, that we are finding the temp.size if it is less than. So we can define that size of this particular. So right now, for example, if you'll go to this one, so we can see that 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11. So 11 is that size. The same thing you can. So same thing we can continue. For example, is it audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now here you can see the temp.size. So will temp.size, it will be the size, it will be around, for let us consider 15 or 20. I think 1 2 3 4 8 9 10 11. So 11. So it is less than 100. Rest of the 100 minus 11. So rest of the byte it's going to be appended with this delimiter. So 100 minus 11, so rest of the 89 byte it's going to append with this record delimiter. So these things only have been done in this one. So for temp.size less than 100, temp equal to, so after for loop, this one will 89 times this one it's going to execute. Temp equal to temp plus record delimiter. After that it will come out from this one, and next we are going to keep it into buffer. Another variable buffer you are keeping, so buffer equal to buffer plus temp plus backslash n. By using this backslash n, next one next pointer will come to this line. So once we'll do that backslash n, so next one will come to this one, and after that, if you want to write second one will start from this pointer and it will write up to 100 bytes, and after that again you will put that backslash n. So again it's going to write that third one. So like this it's going to continue. So this is that pack function. So very simple pack function. So two string variable defining, one is that temp, one is that buffer. So initially in temp we are going to pack each and every variable. So usn plus delimiter plus name plus delimiter plus branch plus delimiter plus semester. So everything had have been packed in this temp, and once it has been packed, after that as it is fixed length record we are making that one of 100 bytes, or if you want 50 bytes you can write down 50 also. So according to you, you can make that how what should be that size of each record. After that we are writing into buffer, and after that providing this plus backslash n to start that next record into that next new line. So this is for packing. So you can see that in main function first we are going to read the data. Once we read those data, after that we are going to pack all those variables into buffer and writing, and right now we have to write the content of the buffer. So simply what you have to do, writing that buffer. So all the contents it's there, where all the contents it's there in this buffer. So now I need to write this buffer. So what we can do, that you can see that buffer how we are writing. Just now I have shown you that one program how to write that names. So simply this buffer how you can write down by using this line, file buffer. So here you can see that to write it into that buffer, first of all you have to open the file. You have to open the file for what purpose? You have to open the file for writing. So writing means they defined appstream. Appstream it's for both reading and writing. So in appstream you have ifstream also, offstream also. So ifstream also, offstream also. So that's why it's mandatory to define what should be that mode, whether it's for writing or whether it's for reading. So as we have to write, so we are defining it as IOs out. So opening this one.txt IOs out and append. So append why? So first record we wrote. After writing this first record, after writing this first record, maybe I have to write down that second record. So second record I can't start it from here itself. If you will write it here itself, it's going to erase this content. So for that reasons it's appending at the end. So appending at the end means next line is going to append. As we provided plus backslash n, next one is into appending into that next line. So that one was that meaning of that append. So IOs append. So appending to that next line. And after that simply we are writing the content of that buffer. Already we packed it into this buffer, and we are writing this buffer only by using this object, that file. So this object is nothing but it's an appstream object. So by using this object we are writing it. So as same thing in previous example, we did this offstream f1 and we wrote it f1 names, but here already we packed all those things into this buffer. We are writing this particular buffer content, and after that closing this function. So now up to this much, what you can do, that if you'll write down this much program, so with this string three function you can execute first option. That one is that add number of records, or add n number of students records. So add n number of student records, you need this read data pack function and write to file. So same things will continue for I think 2 to 3 program, the things will be same. So is that clear everyone? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes sir.
Okay, so so this read function, pack function and write to file, I hope so that it's easy and you can do it very easily. Only the thing is that you have to sit and execute once, and you have to study once, and you have to execute once by yourself at home. As it is online classes, So only I am explaining in theoretically. So after that, you just try if possible. If you can't, then also we can't see. We can't force you. So you just say that whether you can do it or not. Next is now other three functions we have to implement. This is delete, modify, and search. So for delete or modify, you have to search. Until or unless you are going to search any information, you can't delete that content from that file, or you can't modify any content from that file. So now for delete and now for searching, what we are doing, we have to implement that unpack function. Already I told, explained this unpack function during class. So now in this unpack function, what we are doing? So in packing, you can see that leave all those parts. So first field is, it should be what I told, that it should be in same sequence. Otherwise, we'll get that fragmentation error. First is USN, next is name, next one is branch, next one is semester. While unpacking, you have to check after USN, this delimiter. After name, this pipe delimiter. After branch, this pipe delimiter. But after semester, you need this record delimiter, not this pipe delimiter. So most of the students doing this mistake is to write this pipe delimiter itself. So after semester, it will be record delimiter. So if you have to search, you have to unpack. Now you have lots of clothes or stuff in your briefcase. So if you have to search for any item, obviously you have to unpack. Until or unless you are going to unpack, you can't search it. So same way, you have to unpack. So how to unpack it? So first, you can see that USN. So initially, we are going to do this USN.erase. It doesn't mean that USN is making USN string as empty. But just I will write for understanding empty. You are making this USN. Maybe in USN, some junk values, it can be there. So just to make it empty, so Rajat, now you are joining. Hello. Rajat, are you there? So now here you can see that first is that USN. So how we are going to unpacking while. So this one is that while loop, with the help of this while loop. And where we are going to pack it, we are packing it into buffer. So therefore, obviously, from this buffer only, you have to unpack. So you can see that buffer I. So buffer I not equal to this particular delimiter. So now here it will go. So this one we kept it into. This one, it's there in buffer. So right now here that buffer I. So if I'll write down buffer I, so I it's starting from zero. So buffer zero will be which one? Buffer zero will be one. Next one will be one. Next one will be 0, 1, 2, 0, 1. This is 1, this one is 2, so next one will be 1, next one will be this particular 5 delimiter. So until or unless it's going to reach to this delimiter, so what you have to do, that you have to extract it. So you have to extract this one. So while buffer I not equal to this delimiter, what you are doing, you are keeping all those things into USN. Initially USN was what? Empty. Now in empty string, with first one, buffer I plus plus. Here you see that again it's given as I plus plus, post increment. So first one is that zero. After zero it will be one. So first zero is which one? One. After that one is which one? One. So one, first is zero plus one is one. Next one plus one is 11. So we are keeping this 11 into this USN. Is that clear? We are keeping that 11 into this USN. So first one is that 0, 1, 2. So S2 will not continue. So these two we are going to do. Initially USN is empty. USN equal to empty string plus 1 equal to 1. Second iteration, what will happen in second iteration? USN will be what? Next USN equal to 1 plus 1. It will be 11. So once you will got this one, so you are keeping it into USN. So once you will keep it into USN, so after that what you can do, that you can keep these things, and after that you can go ahead. So now next field is name. So we'll unpack this name. So if you have to unpack this name, what you have to do right now, our pointer will be in this one. So right now our pointer will be in this one. So we should increase by 1. So once we'll increase by 1, we'll come to this one. So same thing it's doing by using this I++. So if you'll do this I++, at that time it will come to this location. So once it will come to this location, again you are using same thing, name.erase and name equal to name plus name. So buffer I not equal to this delimiter, name equal to name plus buffer I plus plus. So you are doing the same thing. So again it will be 1 1 and 1 1. So after doing all those things, next what will be there? So first it will take this one, after that it will take this one. When it will come to this delimiter, it's going to stop. So once it's going to stop, so at that time what will happen? So again we are going to increase it by I++. So I++ increase means we'll come to this one. So same thing doing here also, you can see that I++ doing. So once we'll do that I++, next field is branch. So now branch it's going to unpack and using this particular delimiter. So once we'll do all those things, after branch you can say, after this branch we are coming here. So after this delimiter, again we have to do plus plus, will come here 1. So it will come 1. Next we'll go to this 1. But at last, after that, you will get this record delimiter. Now not that pipe delimiter. So in code itself you can see that, buffer I not equal to record delimiter. Till now it was delimiter as pipe symbol, but right now this dollar as an record delimiter. So this one is semester. What exam do you do? So here you can see semicolon thing change again. So this one will be branch. So this buffer, so this is not sem, it will be semester equal to buffer I plus plus, and will in output this semester. So this is about unpacking. So this unpacking, you can see that how it has been done. So it has to be in sequentially in that order. So if you will not do it in that order, so at that time you will get that fragmentation error or search will not be correct. So in which order you are packing USN name, branch, semester, in same order you have to do it. And remember this one, that buffer I not equal to pipe delimiter up to the last field, and last, so up to the last field, before that last field, and at last field it will be record delimiter. Is that clear? And USN in this one, what you are doing, you are doing that post increment buffer I. So initially will be first 0 0, next one will be 1. So that's why buffer I plus plus. So remember those things while writing the code for this unpack function. So this is for unpacking whatever has been packed. So is that clear, this unpack function? So next program also same thing will continue. next program also will continue the same thing. So I will just show you this, why again and again telling that 2-3 second program, you can see that third program also. Third program also you can get same, only the changes it will be of variable length record. Everything will be same, read data, pack function will be more simple because we no need to add thing. Next, unpack will be same for the second, third program also. Search will be almost somewhat same and main function also will be same. So if you can understand one program, so many, 2-3, 3-4 programs you can do it by yourself. Is that clear? So just try to understand this unpack, it's clear or not. Already once explained in class, again explaining, check that if you're finding any difficulties, you can let me know. So this one is that unpack function. So how you are going to unpack that USN name, branch, semester. So once you will unpack it, after that we can go for search. After that we can go for that search function. So this search function, you can see that search which particular key has to be searched. So before going to this one, let us go to this main function. So in main function you can see that case 4, cout, enter the key, that which key has to search. So let us execute it and show. So for example, I am going to add only 2 on the record 1-1. Now if I have to go for search, fourth option is for search. If I will write down 2-2, at that time you can see that found the key. So it's going to display this record 2-2-2. Now next, again if I will search, for example 4, if I will write down 1-1, so at that time I can see that we can display this record. Again 4, if I will write down 1-2, at that time it will show you that key not found. So at that time again you can see that key not found. So this one is that how you can, now we will see that how we are going to implement this search function. So in this search function, so you can see that int main, so count, choice, length, so now here search that entered that key. Just now we have seen that if you'll give that key as 11, it's going to show you that particular record. If it is 1-2 at that time, that search not found. So this thing has been implemented here. So you can see that search. So first of all, what it's going to do, it's going to open that file. So in which file you wrote all those information, that file it's going to open. So how we are going to open that file, file.open, and name of the file is 1.txt. Now you can see that in which mode you are going to open that file, for reading. That means searching means not writing anything, obviously it will be reading. So for reading you are going to open that file, file.open1.txt IOs in. For input mode you are going to open that file. So now again, already we have seen that file.eof, until or unless end of file. So hold the file, it's going to search from beginning to end of file. So how we can do it by using this while loop, that while not file.end of file, it's going to execute. So initially what they are doing, that buffer, it's going to erase that content of that particular buffer. Now once you are going to erase that buffer, so after that it's going to keep this, hold the content, that get line file comma buffer, hold the content of file you are keeping into buffer. So here I will show you that output of buffer so that it will be more clear. So now you can see that in buffer what is there. So you can see that buffer all those content is there. So what is that meaning of that file dot get line? So here you can see that buffer what are the content is there. So in file whatever is there we are going to just copying it into buffer. So all the file content it's going to be copied into this buffer. So how we are going to open this file? If stream file, in file whatever the content will be there, so it's going to be copied into this particular buffer. Now again I will show you another one. For example, 422. So now you can see that what will be that in buffer. So in buffer first will be that first record. So first one will be that first record because it's going to be end of file. So first one will be first record, second one will be second record. So hope so that you can see it's too small. So in second time you can see that in buffer what is that file comma get line file comma buffer. So first it's going to get that first buffer. Second time as I am searching 22, so for that reason both the buffer, that buffer first buffer will be with that 11 and second buffer will be with 22. So all those things it's going to be stored. So this one is that how this get line function is going to work. Now unpacking. So after that you can see that unpack. So once you'll get it, so what you are going to unpack, you are just going to unpack all those fields like name, USN, branch, all those things you are unpacking. So in first case you can see that, where is the output? Yeah, so in first cases you can see that first it's going to take this one and after that unpacking it's not going to find out anything. Second cases it's going to unpacking all the fields. Although we need only USN, but it's unpacking all the fields. Now it will take out this USN and we'll check out that input USN. Here, so now unpacking, it's going to unpack each field if key. The key whatever you given, for example, 22. So if 22 equal to USN, this USN from where you will get it? You will get it from this unpack. So in unpack, you will get it from this one, this USN. So if it's going to be match at that time, we'll say that found the key. The record is that particular buffer. The record is that particular buffer. So you will see that that buffer where it is. So you can, so second one we are going to unpack, we'll get that 22 as an USN and input is 22. If 22 equal to 22 at that time the record is this whole the buffer. So this one is that how you are going to display that particular records. So first if you'll give that 11, so it's not going to match it. Second time if you'll come 22, it's going to match. So at that time it's going to display that particular record. Next line it's required for deletion. So that one is that position. How we'll get that position? Till now we know that how to seek a file in C++ by using seekg, by using seekp, tellg, tellp, it's to get that particular put pointer or get pointer. So tellg is to tellg is to just throw that particular get pointer. So what will be that pointer will be there, what will be that location or what will be that position where that cursor will be there, so that position it's going to throw. So now here we'll show you practically that how it's going to show. For example, let me show you that cout position. So see out position, so we'll display this position. So what we'll do, we'll write the program again, we'll execute this program. So let me consider I have taken three record, one adding three record, first one is one, second one is two, third one is three, after that four I will give that enter that key as 2. So that position you can see that it's coming as 919. So is it visible to everyone? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
I think here some mistake is there. You can see that 22 is there, I think. I will delete that file, then only I'll execute. Yes, this file will delete and will execute. So 1, let us re-record 1, 1, 1, 1, next is 2, 2, 2, 2. 4. So now you can see that entered that key. So by using that get line, we are getting buffer, first buffer, this one, next second buffer, this one, and after that third buffer, second buffer only required because 2 is there. If 3 would have been there, it had gone to the third one. Now found the key. The record is of 2, 2, 2. So and that position it's 205. So right now you see that interestingly that how it's going to display this position. So now you can understand if you have to find out that what is the size of that file, you can use this position tell g. So file dot tell g, so this particular functions you can use that why this file dot tell g is going to be used. So here you can see that 205 it's printed. So if you'll open that. So if you'll open that this one, so you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it will be a total of 100. Okay. And 1 will be for this one, 101. So 1 will be for backslash 1. So 101 plus 101, it will be 204. So how it is 204, and after that again it's given. Where it is. So here you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is that 100 plus 101. This one will be also for 101. So 101 and 101 it will be 202. But how it is 205? I think there is some mistake. So there is some mistake. You can see that which is not coming. 4 field. Last one is not coming, isn't it? Last one is coming branch. So we have that problem with semester as we did. Semester, yes. So this one was the mistake. So that's why it is not coming. So 1, so how many record? 3 record, for example, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, next is 3, 4. Now is it printing properly? No, still it's not printing properly. We have that again error. Next painting properly. We'll delete it and we'll execute. Let's say now it's going to display it properly or not. So 1, 1, 2. I think it's fine right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is fine. So now you can see that 2 we have given. So it is coming 2 times. Their data inserted wrongly. So let us see that first again. 1, how many 3 record you want? 1, 1, 1. Next 1, 2, 2, 2, 2. Next 3. Next 4. Next I am searching 2, 2 not 5. So you can say that keys 2, so buffer 1 will be this, buffer will be this one. So the record is 2 to this one is given as 205. So how 205? Let's see. So if you'll take that 100, this one 100, how many is there? Let us see. So 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So it should be 101. This is 101. So this one will be 202. But why it is 205? Then it means wrong. So here somewhere some mistake is there, 205. It should be 200 and semester. Let us see here this semester again, anywhere mistakes is there or not. Semester.age buffer something. Buffer.age control F sem. Key modify. Here I think Sam is defined, so that is the not required. Here semester.erage main. So in search key file position. Okay. Now let's see if searching or not correct. So this right now here you can see that entered that key, so that buffer 1 and buffer 2, so it's searching properly. If you are giving it as 2, so it's going to display that record as 2. Now position, it has been defined 205. Now let us see that whether deletion is going to happen correctly or not. So if I have to delete, I am going to define it as 2. So the record 2 is this one, so it has been deleted or not. 4 is searching, 3, 2 is for deletion. Enter the key to delete, so 2. It has been deleted. Now let us see that by searching we'll get it or not. Again 4, the key is 2. So the here you see that as this position 205 is wrong coming, so that's why it's not correctly deleting. So that record is there. So this record is there. So let us see F1. Yes, 2000. We'll run it and again we'll check this position. It's not coming correctly. It should be correct. Now adding one record, I'll just add one record. How many records? 1, 2, insert 2 record. 1, 1, 1, 1, 2. Search for 4. 2 searching, 2 not 4. Still it's not correct. Where is that mistake? Position equal to 0. Now key find that position equal to position dot tell g. Now if you have to delete 2, 2, 4. Not found. So still this one is mistake. So enter that record file dot position equal to file dot tell g. So see out getline buffer unpack. So right now this see now still now this searching is working, but that position it's not working because it should come as 101 plus 101 202 it should come. So if it is coming 202 then only it will be correct. Position equal to file dot tell g. Again let me check. So now if we'll execute only one record will execute, it should give that position. So one adding one, 4, 1. So 102 it's giving. So one more it's providing. Okay. So if it is giving as position equal to 102, so at that time what we can do that we should deduct that 102 only, so then only it will be correct. Now if I'll run it again. One, two records adding. Enter the choice 4, will give 2. It's getting 306. Now, for example, we'll delete 2. 2, Now for search to not found. So now I think it's solved. Yeah, so we solved it right now. You can say that if you have to delete, then this position has to mark with this special character. So here you can see that how it's happening, that position dot tell g. It's going to give you that pointer that where it's going to available. So right now here you can see that as we defined, for example, 4, if I'll give that 1. So as we define that 1, so first record, so in first record it's showing that position as 104. So first record, that position it's showing as that 104. So you can say that 104 will be where, so this record, wherever they are in 104, so 101. So this is 100, another one will be for plus backslash n. So another one, they are defining it for 100 plus backslash n. So this one is that 101. So next 2, 3 and 4. Maybe there are some kind of garbage for what I can say that, for example, right now I am keeping this one here. So if I will keep it here and after that if I will run this program, let me close it and build now, build and run. So if I'll run it here, then 4, if I'll say that, for example, 1. So you can see that position, it's now showing as 114. That position is showing as 114. So why it's showing? Because I am going to move this particular cursor in this one. So how many white space and whatever the space will be there, you can, it's going to count. So again, if I'll run, you can see that it's going to increase. For example, if I will close it and after that again I am going to run it, for example, 4, if I will say that 1, so you can see that 4 times, previously it was 114 and after that now it has become as 118, so each time we are opening that file and if you will do something, that position is going to be changed. So what you have to do, while doing this program, just you have to delete this file and after that you have to create this particular file, for example, 1.txt. So let me write some other name, 2. So let me write that 2, for example, right now executing this program. Now if you'll write down 1, will add 2 records, 1, and after that now searching 4, it's going to search that record, find 204, that position has been found as 204. Now again if I'll search for 4, and if you'll define 1, it will show you that 103. So it will show you that 103. So by using this position.tellg, you will find out where that particular cursor is going to point. Now this position where we need, so this position we need to delete. If you have to delete that particular record, we need this position. So for that reasons, what we are doing, we are making that one as a flag 1. If record found, otherwise it will be not found. If not flag, that means not found. If that flag is not going to make it as 1, so at that time that record not found and returning that position. So from this search, we are returning that position. So in search, there are two things is there. One is that getLine function. So by using that getLine function, we are taking that whole the buffer content and after that we are unpacking. And the keywords, whatever given by that user, if it is matching, at that time it will show you that record found, and along with this we are returning that position. That means at last where that particular cursor is there. So we'll return that position. That position will be required to delete that particular record. And if it is not there at that time, it will show you that not found. Now delete function. Next is modify. It's not required. It's not there in syllabus. Will not go through. Although it is. So next is that delete from file. So in delete from file, whatever that position we are returning, so it's required for to delete from that file. So simple. If it's going to return any position at that time only, it's going to execute this particular code. So in this one, what it's doing that it's going to open that particular file. So which file it's going to open? That tomb. Here we modified it as tomb. So it's going to open that particular file tomb. So that file dot open. So we are opening in which mode? AppStream. So you have to define it as IOS out. So once you will get it, so after that what we will do, that whatever position you will get, that will do that 102. So why you are going to do this 102? You have to come back. For example, it has retrieved this. For example, this position is 101 202. So if I have to come to that beginning of this one, what I have to do? 202 minus 101. If I'll do, then only this cursor will be in this position. So if I have to delete this particular record, I have to mark it with some star mark. Or if I have to delete this record, I have to bring this particular cursor at that initial point, and I have to mark that one with some special character. So once you are going to make this special character, so at that time only, next time if you'll go to search that record, you will not get it. So that one is the techniques for deletion. So in deletion technique, what happened? For example, right now here 2 is there, here 3 is there. Now the record with USN number 3 you have to delete. So if you have to delete it, what you have to do? Just you have to come back to that in the beginning of this. So position whatever will be there. For example, third record, I am searching third record. The position of third record will give it this location. So from this location, you have to come back to this initial location. How you can come back to that initial location? Position equal to position minus 101. As it is fixed length record, so 100 plus 1 is for 100 plus backslash n. 1 is for backslash n, so 101. So that position minus 101, if you'll do, you'll come to this initial position. Once you'll come to this initial position, you are going to put this particular del mark. So here you can see that position equal to position minus 101. So whatever that positions will come, will deduct that 101, will come back to that initial position, and after that will seek to that position. The file dot seek key. Already we know that seek key, that position, that how much byte. So for example, if it is 100, if it is 50, then it will be 50 from where? Beginning. So it will put that pointer in this location itself. And after that, we are going to just file dot put del mark. So on that position, we are going to put this del mark and making that flag as 1. So putting this del mark, and after that making this flag as 1. So that means that record has been deleted. If not flag at that time, return 0. That means record not found, we can't delete it. So this is that, or else return 1. This is success. So this one is that how you are going to delete. So same thing in delete main function, you have to write down that, enter the key which one you want to delete. So depending on that key, first you are going to search. So you can see that in delete function we have this search. So position will get it from that search, whatever that key will be there of that key, that position will get. And once we'll get that position, we'll do that position equal to position minus 101. Why 101? Because fixed length record and 1 is for backslash n. And we'll come back to that initial location. And after that, we are going to seek to that position from the beginning. And we'll put that del mark on that position so that it can be marked as delete, and will make that flag equal to 1. So this one is that second program. So now third program is almost same. So I will share. I have shared this particular manual. So you can try from your end to execute this program and send me the screenshot of that output through mail. Is that clear to everyone? So send me that screenshot of that output through mail by tomorrow morning, or try to send it. Hello?
Yes, sir.
So can you execute this program today?
Yes, sir.